Storyboard today, Gordon Harris CEO Fred Cook on PR in the digital age, how Zet's marketing strategy clicked with the consumer, and an exclusive preview of GoDaddy's latest TVC. Hello and welcome to Storyboard. I'm Pavni Mittal. With social media and real-time marketing becoming the new frontier for brands, agencies from creative to media to PR are changing their business models, company structures and even talent mix to keep pace with the changes. Today, we're going to take a look at how PR agencies are changing to ensure that their clients are in the conversations and are able to influence the conversations. Joining me from New Delhi is the CEO of Global PR Major Gordon Harris, Fred Cook. Fred, good to have you on the show. Could you first give me a sense of how digital has changed the way Gordon Harris functions?
In the last 5 years, digital has changed everything that we do in communications. And because of that, we've had to change the way that our company is structured. We used to have a very generalist kind of structure with everybody sort of doing the same thing. Recently, we introduced a new structure called G4, which has four communities of people who specialize in different aspects of communications. And one of those specialties is digital, because we found that the technology today is too complex for everyone in the company to understand it. So we need specific people who are experts in digital to help us with our clients.
So how have you equipped yourself to deal with and analyze real-time data?
Well, when we created G4, we created something called the Bridge. And the Bridge is in every one of our offices, including our office in Mumbai. It is a multimedia real-time engagement center. And it is complete with televisions, print media, and also all the online tools for monitoring online. And from the Bridge, we can see what's trending online, we can see what's happening in the news and on talk shows, and then we can insert our clients into that conversation in real time as these events are taking place. And we found that has been a very effective tool in sort of getting the message out in a very relevant way.
Okay, so how do you qualitatively analyze the chat on social media?
The way we work at the Bridge is both with technology and with people. And we have all the latest technology to analyze the commentary in social media and do all of the measurement and analysis of that. But then the humans curate the process by looking at the stories that are being discussed in the news and online, and then deciding how our clients can participate in that conversation. So we create all of the engagement ourselves, all of the content for Twitter, Facebook, for broadcast television, infographics, you name it. We create that in our offices in real time and then deliver that across all these different channels. So it's both technology and the human element.
And what about collaboration? How important has it become to, say, you know, work with creative agencies and media agencies? And how easy or rather difficult is that?
We recently did an event in London for Cadbury around the Brit Awards, which is a big televised music program. And in our Bridge in the London office, we had the advertising agency, the media agency, our agency, and the client all working hand in hand to respond in real time to what was happening on this television program. And we would be constantly sending out and creating, we would be creating designs to put out online from Cadbury. We had a legal team there making sure that what we did was all appropriate. And then we had the client there to approve everything. So we had four agencies working in real time to make sure that we were taking advantage of this event. And Cadbury ended up being the number one brand talked about during the Brit Awards.
For agencies like yours to work real time and deliver results, you need to be able to respond quickly and take decisions fast. Are clients giving you the power to do that?
Well, it really depends. The empowerment depends on the client. Some clients are a little risk averse and they're not as agile as they need to be to respond in real time. Our research has shown when there's a topic online or in social media that you have 4 hours in which you can respond and still be relevant. So a client has to be agile enough and ready to respond within an hour or 2 hours to any topic that's happening online. Some of our clients are at that point where they're very engaged and able to do that. Other ones, it takes a little bit longer.
So then how do you get clients on board?
Usually in the beginning with a client, there's a period of time where you have to gradually test this new technology to make sure they're comfortable with it. But once they see the results, they usually get very excited and want to do more. We're currently doing that for McDonald's in our Chicago office. We have a whole team of people who are working online to engage on a 24/7 basis for McDonald's because they feel they are ready to have that conversation with the consumer and they want to be participating. Other clients like to see examples of how that works, and then they go in a little more slowly.
And what about talent? Has the people mix changed too?
Well, as I mentioned before, we changed our structure completely 3 years ago, and we had a single model of generalists that we had used for more than 50 years, and we threw that out, and we created four communities of specialists who were experts in strategy, creative, and engagement, and in client management. And so that's the route we've taken, and we do a lot of investment in technology and a lot of investment in training, because we believe our people really need to be deep experts in the areas that our clients care about.
Okay, so lastly, what's the road ahead for PR agencies, the need of the hour?
I think two things. You have to have people who are out there looking and exposing themselves to everything that is happening in the outside world. And then secondly, you have to have the ability to invest in those things and the courage to try things before they are tested and proven. So we do a lot of experimentation in our agency, and we're trying new technologies all the time. Some of them work, some of them don't work, but we're constantly innovating, I think, as we go along.
Challenging times for PR agencies. Thanks for your time, Fred.
All right.
We're going to take a short break here. When we come back, how Zest marketing strategy clicked with consumers. Welcome back, you're watching Storyboard. With the launch of Zest in August this year, Tata Motors entered the fast-growing compact sedan segment. Zest is also the first car to be launched under Tata Motors' new strategy to turn around the company's weak domestic business. The marketing strategy was simple: generate buzz throughout the year and ensure that activations across all mediums drive footfalls and sales. I caught up with Tata Motors' passenger vehicles marketing head, Delna Avari, to understand what the ROI on activations, especially an unusual innovation in print, is. Listen in. How important was the launch of Zest for Tata Motors?
So as you know, we launched the Horizon Next strategy, which is how we are taking forward the transformation of Tata Motors. Yeah. And Zest is that first product after our announcing that strategy. So obviously, it was extremely important for the organization that we got it right. The way we approached the market was we understood where the consumer need was.
Okay.
For us, it was about taking feedback from the market.
Mm-hmm.
The way we designed the Zest mm-hmm. was around that entire philosophy. We've been true to our strategy as far as Horizon Next is concerned, which is the entire pillars of design, drive, connect, the kind of products that we take out there. We've been confident about it. It's we've not had a very strong play in this market, and really that's what we've done with the Zest.
When you sat down to design the marketing strategy, what did you do differently this time, as in the approach to market Zest?
It really was about getting the medium right.
Okay.
The marketing entire mix. And we were very clear that it was just not about doing a 360-degree mm-hmm. strategy as such. It was every single medium that we used. We looked at how would we innovate in that medium
okay.
and have the ripple effect of that medium take it forward.
Okay.
To give you an example. Whether it was TV, print, digital, outdoor, activation, each of them we had a very strong lead idea.
Mm-hmm.
And taking that idea, we went forward. So, for example, on TV, we decided to partner with, obviously, Star Plus, which is a very, very strong channel out there. It's the biggest. And what we did is we partnered with them on all their 9 primetime shows. Mm-hmm. And you have the protagonists go out there and actually talk about having taken a test drive in the Zest. So you created for an entire week. You had, through primetime, you actually had people coming out there and saying, we've test driven the Zest, have you? So you created a connect immediately with the audience. Now, this is an innovation on TV. Simultaneously, you have the normal TV campaign that's running as well, but you've actually created an entire conversation and a ripple effect in that medium. Similar things were done for the print medium, for the digital medium, for the on-ground medium. So each medium, we actually created something innovative, took that medium forward in a manner of such.
Okay. New celebrities. There was a time with IFA. There was, I think you had a competition online, and that with Ranveer Singh, there was a tie-up there. Then again, television stars. What is this strategy using celebrities?
So what's very interesting with the Zest is we unveiled it in February.
Yeah, at the Auto Expo.
And the commercial launch really was in August, September. So keeping the buzz interest alive and continuously connecting with the audience was really the challenge. Mm-hmm. And what we thought is that how do we... It's also a very interesting mix if you look at the Zest consumer group. It's not something that you can just immediately put down as a demographic. Mm-hmm. It really is an upwardly mobile customer. It's someone who's comfortable with design, technology. At the same time, it's also mass. From that time to now, IFA was something that we were the principal sponsors of. And with IFA, therefore, we used a lot of our association out there to get people to see the product, see mm-hmm. the Zest in a new way, to actually have even people who are stars actually enjoy the product, engage with the product, they signed the product, they sat in the product, they talked mm-hmm. about it. So it was just a very quick connect with the audience. The Star Plus, what I mentioned to you, really is about, again, a different kind of audience. So Tata Cars, for instance, have had a certain kind of consumer who has been very easy to get along with, or understand the brand, or understands the brand very easily. Sometimes we found that that brand is not always understood by women. So how do you build that connect? How do you build that connect? And Star Plus, some of the biggest soaps, you actually have a lot of young ladies who actually came out there and said that, you know, we have experienced the cars. So you actually had that kind of a connect that was building as well with the audience.
The initiative that you did with the leading daily, what was the ROI on that when you had a key that was attached and that said, you know, test drive?
There has been such a change in the way the cars have evolved from Tata Motors. People needed to actually experience it. So every initiative we did, even the one on Star Plus, was about having a very clear test drive, right? The initiative when we came up with print, how do we kind of get more and more people to experience the product? So we actually put a physical key in there.
Yeah.
Now, the launch communication, if you look at it, would have always been a nice full page or a 4-page jacket, all of that. You do that, but you by adding just that little element of a physical key, which we incidentally barcoded. So you actually had a barcoded key that you took in. And on an app, you just scanned it, and all your data was captured out there once you took a test drive. So we drove a lot of traffic into the showrooms. While I cannot give you investment numbers, I can tell you that we had actually a 6 times higher reaction to that communication than we've had to a similar communication with the same publication. So with Times of India, same kind of communication in the past. For this communication where you just added that
the key,
you had a 6 times higher kind of walk-in or reaction to the communication.
Okay, so you're saying when you say 6 times higher, you're attributing that to the prop, or you're saying the kind of media space that you gave?
Definitely the media space, but I'm also doing a correlation to the fact that the kind of communication you had there, it got people excited to come in there. What was also interesting is post this, we did a feedback on did people recall it. So you actually had an 84% recall of that communication by readers. And you actually had 63 or 64% people say that this was an innovation that they've not seen in a while. We were also very clear that who were we pushing in there? Were we getting people who were just random? So we actually had a lot of checks even at the dealerships that did you have the right quality of people walking in, or was it people who just thought it's a contest? You'll be happy to know that they were actually people who really wanted, because if you won the car, Mm-hmm. You still have to pay all the taxes and all of that. So it's not free, mm-hmm. right? So you got the right kind of people to actually walk in and to experience the product. So from that point of view, I think it was probably one of our most successful campaigns. It's also something that has now put back a lot of pressure on saying, okay, what next?
Yes.
Because now you have, when you see those kind of returns on your communication, you have a pressure saying, okay, what next?
Which is what I was going to come to. But first, I'm going to ask you about competition. This is obviously compact sedan is another fast-growing segment, but it has stiff competition. You have Honda Amaze and Swift Dzire, two big ones in the segment. What has been your competitive strategy?
Look, we have a very strong product itself, right? At the end of the day, the Zest is an incredibly good product that we have there. Lot of first-in-class features. So forget the fact that the design itself matters a lot here, and the design, it's a beautiful car. A lot of people say it looks like a compact sedan from ground up, which it is. But in addition, the kind of things that you've given in terms of the Revotron engine or the multi-drive mode or the Connect Next features, these are all segment-first features which have got the imagination of people. At the end of the day, what you have to offer the consumer has to be extremely strong. And with that, we have the Zest.
Okay.
The Zest is a winner in that. There's no doubt about it. Of course, there are strong players in the market. We respect them. And it's a fair market space, so you are actually competing fairly. You have something good to offer. Our endeavor was that you get more and more people to try our product.
Okay.
They've experienced the Zest, then it's really up to them.
We're going to take a short break here. When we come back, an exclusive preview of GoDaddy's latest TV series. Welcome back, you're watching Storyboard. On Notice Board this week, we're putting up the latest TVC from internet domain name registrar and web hosting company GoDaddy. It's an entertaining film that's trying to sell an intangible product to an audience which may not see the benefits of going online. Here's an exclusive preview of that.
Yeah, not cut. इनका स्टाइल है कमाल टैलेंट से माला माल ये चलते अपनी चाल नट कट लाल बंदे फेमस झटपट नट कट
पर मिस्टर नटकट लाल आपका ये टैलेंट अनदेखा रह गया तो इसलिए आज ही रजिस्टर कीजिए अपना नाम GoDaddy.com पर इंटरनेट पर पहचान बनाओ दुनिया को दिखाओ GoDaddy.
The number one goal we are trying to achieve with this campaign is obviously to drive awareness around why it is important to build your identity on the net. As the internet grows in India, and more people come online, it's important to actually build your identity and secure your domain name on the internet. So we hope this will encourage people, small businesses and consumers, to come forward and get their domain name on the internet and make sure that they have their identity in the online world as well.
मेरा बेटा राजेश वर्मा गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट बनेगा.
राजेश वर्मा सर्जन बनेगा.
शेफ बनेगा. पायलट बनेगा.
राजेश वर्मा संगीत सम्राट.
कमांडो बनेगा.
राजेश वर्मा क्रिकेटर बनेगा.
लेकिन डियर एंथू पापा, सिर्फ एक राजेश वर्मा को मिलेगी अपनी पहचान.
GoDaddy.
आज ही रजिस्टर कीजिए अपना नाम GoDaddy.com पर. इंटरनेट पर पहचान बनाओ दुनिया को दिखाओ GoDaddy.
That film is expected to end next week. And with that, it's a wrap on the show for this week. Stay connected though. Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, we're all over the internet. I'll see you next week. Until then, thanks for watching.